الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، حي على السلام، حي على السلام، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله، نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونتوب إليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه، وأشهد أن محمدًا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله داعي إلى رضوانه. أما بعد، إخوتي في الله، أيها الآباء الكرام وأمهات الفضليات، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى قائلًا في كتابه بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. All thanks and praises due to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the most gracious, the most merciful. We thank Him, and as Muslims we testify that there is none worthy of worship and praise except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final and seal of all prophets and messengers Allah sent to guide mankind from the darkness of disobedience towards the nur of Iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be amongst the guided ones, Kareem. My dear brothers and sisters in the deen, fathers as well as mothers, I first of all admonish myself standing before you and all of you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear Allah, the exalted one. Allah says in the Quran, Ya ayyuhallatheena amanu. He called on you, the believers, O you who believe. Ittaqullah. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Haqqa tuqati. As he ought to be feared. ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. And do not die except in the state of Islam. أحبتي في الله, my dear beloved ones in the deen. موضوعنا اليوم بإذن الله تعالى, our topic today by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be الدعاء, supplication. الدعاء, supplication. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Your Lord said, Allah, call me and I will answer to your call. Your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ادْعُونِي, call me, أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ, I will answer to your call. And Allah continues saying another ayah. He said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ الدَّاخِرِينَ. Allah said, for those who are arrogant, feel pompous to call me, they abstain from supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah said, those people, they will enter Jahannam with humiliation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from them, Ya Kareem. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الدُّعَاء هُوَ الْعِبَادَةِ. He said, dua, supplication, is worship. When you stand in salah, you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you make dua. And subhanallah, wherever in the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yas'alunak, they will ask you. And here we say to him, tell them. I.e. for example, Allah said, yas'alunak anil khamri wal maysir. Allah said, they will ask you about alcohol and gambling, etc. Qul, Allah said, say. Allah will order the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to reply to them, say, Qul, say, feehima ithmun kabir wa manafi'u linnas ila akhir ayah. Allah said, tell them that in that gambling and alcohol, the sin is greater. Although people, you know, in this dunya, they are selling, getting money from it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the punishment and the sin is grief when one play gambling and drink alcohol. And Allah said, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْيَتَامَ. They will ask you about the orphans. Allah again said, instructed Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, قُلْ سِي. And so many ayats, Allah said in the Quran as well, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْرُوحِ. They will ask you about the soul, the life, or the ruh. Allah said, قُلْ سِي, tell them. Accept the dua. When it comes to the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about dua, Allah said, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي. He said, when my servants, they ask you about me. When my servants, they ask you about me. Allah did not instruct the Rasul to say, say. He didn't say to him, tell them, say. No. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي. He said, when my servants, they ask you about me, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبًا. Allah said, I am very close. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ. I will answer to the call of the caller if he or she calls me. Subhanallah. Allah says he will answer to the call of the caller. Your duty is to call. Nothing else. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي. When my servants, they ask you about me. فَإِنِّي قَرِيبًا. Allah says, I'm very close. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ. I will answer to the call of the caller if he or she calls me. فَلِيَسْتَجِيبُ لِي. Allah said, they must answer to my call first. وَلِيُؤْمِنُوا بِي. And they must have faith in me. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشِدُونَ. By doing so, they may find the straight path. They will be guided to the straight path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be amongst them, Ya Kareem. May the brothers and sisters in the deen, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَيِّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is حَيِّ. He's shy. Allah is too shy. And also Kareem, He's a generous God. Your Lord, your Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we worship, is Hayy, Kareem. Allah is too shy. and also as well is a generous God. يستحي إذا رفع الرجل إليه يدي أن يردهما سفرا خائبين أو خائبين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I mean the Rasulullah s.a.w. said, Allah is generous and He's shy. He feels too shy for a servant to raise his or her hands up to the sky, crying to Allah, asking Allah. Allah feels shy for that servant to return back his hands without being given what he's asking for. Allah feels shy. All you need to do is to call him, nothing else. If you want to meet the minister, the president, and etc., those VIP, you make appointments. And when you make the appointments, they give you 10, 5 minutes. Even your doctor these days, you make appointments. So go and see your medical doctor. They tell you, okay, you have 5 minutes. I'm not going to sit with you here, discuss things or issues more than 5 minutes. Subhanallah. But when it comes to Allah, everything is with you. The appointment is left with you. Wherever you want to meet Allah, Allah is ready to meet you. Whenever you want to call Allah, Allah is ready to answer to your call. And in the night, the third part of the night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down to the sama' al-dunya and will be calling, saying, who amongst you wants help? Who amongst you seeking forgiveness? Whatever your desires are, Allah said, ask me, I will give it to you. Stand in the night. We all going through difficulties. Every human, everyone has their tests. You know yourself better than anyone else. But you have no one to turn to except Allah. So Allah is Kareem. He's generous. Hayy. He's shy. He's too shy for you to raise your hands up to the sky, calling upon Him without your wishes being given. Nuh alayhi salam. Nuh, when he reached to a level that he could not bear the disbelief and arrogance of his people, he made his dua and called Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, I answer to his dua. He made his dua and Allah accepted his dua. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he also, when his people set up the fire and they decide to take him and throw him into that fire, and then he made his dua. Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. Call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is sufficient for me. In other words, to you Allah, I put my trust and I rely upon you. Save me, protect me as you wish. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْنَا يَا نَارِ. Then Allah command the fire and say, O you the fire, كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمٍ. Allah commanded the fire to cool down. Allah said, be cool. And not only be cool, because when something is too cold, we know, we are in England, when the weather is too cold, sometimes people, you know, become ill, pneumonia and etc., you know, because of the severe cold. So Allah did not say to the fire, become cold and stop there, no. He said, wasalama, and also within the temperature of Ibrahim, in peace, for him to feel comfortable. Subhanallah. وَلَجَعَ إِلَيْهِ مُوسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. Prophet Musa alayhi salam, when he left, or he ran away from Fir'aun and his people. When he ran away from them, and he was going with the Bani Israel, they came by the sea. And then they saw Pharaoh was coming with his troops. Subhanallah. And then they said, Inna la mudrakun. He said to Musa, Musa, they're going to catch us. We're finished. Musa alayhi salam said, Kalla, never. Inna ma'ya Rabbi, sayahdeen. My Lord is with me. He puts his trust in Allah. He knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be there to help him. This is how we have to be. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it has been reported that he visited a man. This man was very sick. And then he said to the man, when he came to the man, or visited the man, and then he asked the man, he said, do you have a dua, supplication that you make? And the man said, yes. He said, what's the supplication that you do? And the man said, he said, I say, Allahumma, in kunta mu'aqiban bi fil akhirah. He said, if you are going to punish me, or have, for example, I've committed a sin, and because of that sin, you're going to punish me the hereafter if I meet you, فَعِجِّلُهُ لِي فِي الدُّنْيَا. Please Allah, bring that punishment now, punish me now, so that you will not punish me in the hereafter. And then the Rasulullah said, Subhanallah. He said, glory be to Allah, لا تُتَيْقُ. You cannot stand the punishment. You are not able to bear the punishment. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hastes his punishment of the hereafter on you in this dunya, you cannot stand it. You cannot bear it. And he said to him, why don't you say, Rabbana, O Allah, atina fi dunya hasana. Give us the best of this dunya. Wa fil akhirati hasana. And the best, the goodness of the hereafter. وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. And save us from the chastisements and punishments of the fire. He said, it's better to say this. Yusuf alayhi salam, it is reported that he said, you know, after a while when he was in prison, and then he said, Allah, I have taken too long in prison. And then Allah said to him, Yusuf alayhi salam, he said, you ask me from prison to put you in prison. As he said, Rabbi, sijnu ahabbu ilay mimma yad'unani ilay. He said, oh Allah, prison is much more better for me than committing zina wa iyadu billah, than disobeying you. And then Allah said, I gave it to you. He said, but if you have asked me otherwise, I would have given it to you as well. Subhanallah. He asked for prison so that Allah will protect him from the fitna. And Allah said, I gave it to you. But now, you're saying you've taken too long in there. But if you would have asked me for something else otherwise, I would have given it to you. Now remember, brothers and sisters, when you're going through difficulties, the statements that you utter. That's why I mentioned this. Some people, when they're in difficulties, or they will say, Allah, I would have preferred to be dead by now. Allah, I would have preferred this situation by now. Seeing negative statements, you have to be very conscious of your words. Ask Allah. Your Lord is a forgiving God. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, according to Sa'id al-Khudri, رضي الله عنه, يسأل الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم سيد ما من مسلم يدعو ليس بإثم ولا قطيعة رحم. He said, whenever a Muslim supplicates to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as long as that supplication is not a supplication of seeking for sinful acts, for example, i.e. for example, if someone wants to commit crime, say, Allah, please give me the ability to go and kill that person. No. You can't ask Allah, make dua for you to disobey Allah. No. And also as well, as long as the dua is not to break the bond, the family bond, the family ties, then the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, illa atahu Allah ihda thalatha, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him one of these three. When you make dua, if the dua you make him is not to disobey Allah, to commit sin, and the dua is not to separate or destroy the family ties or bond, then Allah will give you one of these three. He said, "Imma an yu'ajjila lahu da'wata." Either Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your supplication immediately and give you what he wants or what he desires for you. وَإِمَّا أَن يُدَخِّرَهَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep that dua for you. What you are asking for, Allah will keep it for you for the hereafter, because it will benefit you better, more in the hereafter, not here. وَإِمَّا أَن يَدْفَعَ عَنْهُ مِنَ السُّوءِ مِثْلَهِ. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will use that to remove a trouble, a similar problem from him. Allah will use that to remove a similar burden or problem from you. And that is why, according to the adab of dua, the etiquette and manners of dua, you should not rush, according to the hadith, hasten. What does that mean? The Rasulullah said, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept dua. ما لم يعجل. The dua of the one who does not haste. And then they asked the Rasulullah, what does he mean by that? And then he said, the person who says, I've been asking Allah, I've been praying day and night, but up to now Allah did not answer to my dua. And that made the person to become relent and relax. This is not a good etiquette. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive each and every one of us. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
الحمد لله
والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We thank Allah and the peace and blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters in the deen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your creator. He's a merciful God. He's a forgiving God. His mercy towards you is more than the mercy of your mother towards you. Allah does not want to punish myself and all of you. If Allah was to arrest myself and all of you because of our sins, ما ترك عليها من داب. In another ayah, Allah said, ما ترك على ظهرها من داب. Allah would not leave any creature on the surface if He was to punish us because of our sins. But He's a merciful God. He does not want to punish you. We need to supplicate to Allah. We need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek forgiveness. We are human beings. Of course, we make mistakes day and night. But the problems you are going through, the difficulties that you are in now, No one will save you from it except Allah. Wallahi, no one. No one except Allah. And if you turn to Him, He said, I will answer to your call. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. When my servants they ask about me, Allah said, I'm very close. He does not want any mediator between you and Him. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ. I will answer to the call of the caller if he or she calls me. This is the time. But there is a condition before we go. The dua, it's not about you just making dua. But the basic condition or the primary condition of dua, the first one is ikhlas, sincerity. You have to be very sincere in your dua. You only call upon Allah. Sometimes when people are in the car, up the air, in the plane, in the sea, when the waves, heavy waves, or storm, and etc., about to cause accidents, or maybe the ship or the boat is about to sink, or the flight is about to crash, or the car is about to have accidents or involving accidents, what happens? Subhanallah. They say, my God, oh God, oh God. Even if the person is not a Muslim, he will call upon Allah. Oh my God, God, God. But when Allah saved them, and that's when they start associating Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying, had he not been the pilot, had he not been the driver, he was very skillful, had he not been this and that, and they forgot about Allah. Don't be amongst those ones. These are ungrateful people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to call Him. He said, فَدْعُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Call Allah with all sincerity. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala owns the religion. Only Allah we worship. Only Allah we worship. And secondly, let's abstain from disobedience, oppression, zulm, oppressing one another, eating haram here and there. Look at the man in the hadith, the Rasulullah said, I saw this man dress like the dress, it was not that clean or good looking. His hair was rough, and you can see him like a person, of course, like a person who is really going through difficulties. And he stood there raising up his hands to Allah, making dua, calling Allah, 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 Allah. But the Rasulullah said, وَمَا تَعَمُهُ حَرَامٌ. But what the man eats is haram. وَمَا شَرَبُهُ حَرَامٌ. What the man drinks is haram. وَمَا لَبَسُهُ حَرَامٌ. Even his clothing is haram. فَأَنَّ يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. How would Allah accept the dua of that person? How will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer to his dua? What do you consume? Do we normally do our best and consume the halal? Or we just say, Allah is a forgiving God, He will forgive. That's what the Muslims say these days. Allah knows best. Allah is a forgiving God, He will forgive. Don't be like them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive each and every one of us. May the brothers and sisters in the deen, before I leave this podium, I want to thank the Muslim Ummah, especially the brothers and sisters in this masjid, for your continuous support and contribution to the masjid. And in fact, for you to help yourself. Because whatever you do is for yourself. You're helping yourself. Only Allah will reward you. And the masjid, we've taken the actually endeavor to help our brothers and sisters who intend to go to Hajj, inshallah, every year. So this year, bi-idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we'll have imams who will accompany the Hujjaj going. And we encourage brothers and sisters now to start registering. Inshallah, their names. And when you intend, leave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you wait for the wealth to come, then you will never be wealthy. Except if Allah wills. But do it now and leave everything in the hands of Allah. So we encourage brothers and sisters. We have only 21 spaces more, I think, or 22 actually, available. Some of it has been taken now. So please come and register. They will be leaving, inshallah. The Hujjaj this year will be leaving the 12th of August. And they come back, inshallah, the 1st of September. Bi-idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From here, direct to Medina, and Medina to Mecca. And they have 21 days or 20 days they'll spend there, inshallah. And also, to end the session, we have obligations towards our brothers, Muslims and non-Muslims, especially where we live now. So we have on the 25th of this month, February, an open day, visiting mosque, the mosque day, that we're going to invite more than 300 non-Muslims to come to the masjid that day. We need brothers and sisters who will volunteer. We're not doing it for the Muslims, we're doing it for the non-Muslims. So we do not expect Muslims to come and fill the masjid that day. Those who are going to stay here are the volunteers. And before you stay, so we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide each and every one of us. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد قوموا إلى صلاتكم ورحمة الله.